Hello everyone, Salty Goldfish here for round 4 of Pauper Classic Tuesday. Playing against the Clash of Demonhead, which I'm just going to say. It's from an era when games had awesome cover art. You've never seen the cover art to the Clash of Demonhead? You've got to look up the cover art to Clash of Demonhead. That is from an era. And good looks. Alright, so I can't cast most of my spells. But I still think this is oddly a keep land, because it's 4 lands, 3 spells. Even though they don't do anything, they all get turned on fairly easily. Those are the ugliest mountains I've ever seen. My eyes burn. Just, ugh. White bordered, just, ugh. Oh, there's 2 of them now. So I'm playing against goblins, obviously. He pays the echo. Mug Warmers is a really powerful card. Yeah, ironically, I think it actually is worth me setting back my mana development to have a blocker in play. The real question is, do I want to break this to make a bunch of tokens? I mean, I don't think I do. If I know my opponent's playing Chain Lightning. I mean, Chain Lightning's like... Maybe I should have played an untapped land here to keep up a spell. That is actually a good answer to Mog War Marshal. I mean, it is sad I played 3 spells to basically answer. Thank you. And then next turn I play Ichor Wellspring, draw a card, build my own divination. All right, what is he getting? I mean, Sparksmith, I think, is your go-to here, but oof, I did not want to be Sparksmithing for four. Maybe another Bushwhacker? Those are flunkies. That's fine. I want to equip. That was the I don't even, like, I don't care the way I'm doing it, so. Yeah, might as well just chain her as edictum here. This is a matchup I actually have no idea who's favored. I feel like I've got the advantage because I have cards that aren't 1/1s, but Goblinsk is a really deceptively powerful deck. Like, it can generate a lot of incremental advantage depending on how you build it. I mean, this is the worst Squadron Hawk ever, but it can be the worst Squadron Hawk ever. Still like a Squadron Hawk. I don't know what he's planning, but I'll swing in. Maybe he's hoping to go land, flunkies, Bushwhacker, attack for a million, fire blast you. I mean, if this is his plan of just attacking for two and I attack for three, I win that race. In addition to the fact that I have 7 points of burn in my hand. Why did you two different flunkies? Like, Mog War Marshal's just so much better. Thank you. I don't want to call it the rebirth right now. Feel like I gotta play it a little bit safe and just. I really would like to draw one of my vampires, though. Because now I'm worried about getting burned out. I mean, I'm within bolt, fire, blast range. Hasn't happened yet, so he doesn't have it, but. Doesn't actually make it lethal. If these were goblin grenades. Okay, well, I mean, I kind of knew I was getting close to being burned out. That's about what I want. I mean, I don't think there's really any way I could have played that terribly differently. I didn't really wasn't reckless with my life. I could have made him sacrifice the Sparksmith. I guess that's the difference I could have made. But I don't feel like that was a huge difference. Oof. Had I have thought about the fact he might have smashed smithereens? Yeah, beating the multiple smash smithereens is tough. I mean, there's just nothing really you can do about it. It's sort of a design of the deck. I mean, the deck plays a lot of artifact lands. My opponent gets to play a two mana stone when it hits the dumps me for three. That's a really good card. I hate to play this though. All right. Didn't see anything else really that I want to change. I mean, I don't even mind playing the Galvanblast of Shocks sometimes. Except when they don't work as Shocks. All right, do your worst. Alright. You'll be your guys just kind of getting through. Really played out more into it. So now I can put him into a position where he has to play out more threats. Okay. Into my circle to overwhelm my circle. Goblin Tinker would be kind of a beating here. Bog War Marshal. Good old Siege Rhino effect. The chain landings, I'll throw it back at his Mog Funkies. Thank you. I can just win the race, though. Like he attacks with everything, I just absorb all of the damage, eat one of his 1/1s. Or he dashes and considers the concept of maybe I'll attack and then decides against it. Like, you still have to beat circles. Beating circles isn't easy. What creatures can actually. Do I need to worry about terminating? Technically, Sparksmith is bad if he has another one. What's he getting? I would imagine another Mog, a Marshall. Yeah, because that's pretty much what he needs to do to grind me out. You should at least be attacking to force me to use time. Three, four, five. Yeah, I've got so much mana. I can just basically hide behind my circle, and he has to kill this. I would have definitely gotten a Sparksmith. Though honestly, if he plays the War Marshal, the Sparksmith becomes really bad. Yeah. This lets me keep up enough to stop, take basically only one damage. That other electrolyze is going to be, or electro trickery is going to be important. He wants to throw his goblins at me. At this point, it's not much because I'm at 17. I can just absorb the relevant ones, and I can eat a goblin. Bushwhacker's important. I'm not gonna be, I'm not gonna lie. That was a really good draw for the turn. Let me think this through. All right, 2, 4, 6. I can absorb five of them, which one? Which mean so? These three, which means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I take 10. Can he throw enough at me to kill me? No, I don't think he can. Actually, what I do is I don't prevent one of the twos. I'm taking 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11, 12. Yeah. Games. I mean, he played well. Like, beating Circle Protection Red with goblins is so hard. It's so hard. Like, it's not impossible. Like, he probably would have had me if I hadn't been able to kill him on the crackback. Like, if I'd not been holding, if I'd been holding Lightning Bolt, I'd probably be dead.